Thanks for staying up with us here on a late Sunday night. I'm Trent Bennett. The family says the 15-year-old's name was Eduardo Lopez Escobedo. Officials say they believe this white Toyota struck him along Case Road east of State Road 29 Thursday night. Eduardo was found dead in the ditch. Saturday night, troopers say they found that Toyota SUV and impounded it, but the driver has yet to be found. NBC2's Samantha Romero sat down with Eduardo's family in an exclusive interview today as they're explaining the horror they've been going through for the past 4 days.
Jenny Escobedo is heartbroken after losing her 15-year-old son, Eduardo Dayan. My son, I know he will be remembered with a lot of love because of what he sowed. She can barely hold it together. My son was pure affection. It's a pain no parent ever wants to experience. Everything that my child had was good. Jenny and her husband say Eduardo was their star child any parent could ever dream of. My beautiful child. While sitting in Eduardo's room, they are remembering his life. Jenny says Eduardo was a protector, a stellar student, and put his family above all. Him with his sister, dancing there. He was pure happiness. Now what's left are just memories, like these pictures on a phone. I want you to remember my son as a good boy, because it's the least he deserved. Jenny says Eduardo was the glue to their family, but now they have to lean on each other. I never thought it would happen to me, less because I protect my children a lot, and he died. Troopers say a car hit and killed Eduardo while riding his bike Thursday night, throwing him into a ditch. Days after the crash, Jenny says she found pieces of Eduardo's body on the ground at the crash site. I knew they had a job because that's what I believed, that lifting his body was lifting his remains. And if you see that my child is missing some parts, you need to take them. FHP tells NBC2 troopers were made aware of possible evidence still at the scene Saturday morning. They said they secured it and contacted the medical examiner's office. The family is now asking for justice, and they're calling on whoever did this to turn themselves in. All I ask is for your help to help me find and know why the person who did not have the heart to stop for my son left him lying there. He was not an animal. He was a human being. Reporting in La Belle, Samantha Romero, NBC2.